No, actually, it was for us a logical progression from talent management, because we were at the fringes of closing deals for people being on enough sets, looking at edits, you know, and figuring out whether the heroine has a good entry song or not, you know, whatever. So, all sorts of things. So, when this opportunity came about, I just thought it was a good one to take at various levels. One was that at a personal level, I'm generally attracted to strong women and stories about strong women. I'm a co-founder of Mardar, you know, with Farhan Akhtar and so on. So it appeals to us that I'm surrounded by a disproportionate number of women at work. I'm shooting them all the time as well. It's just one of those things that, and Sonam's been a client for a while, and this came to us from Saibin Quarters, who's a friend of Shanti's, who actually is going to come my partners. And I read the 7-pager, and I think I'm one of the few people who still remembers, who remembered who Neerja Manoj was. Because I was studying in the US at that time when Pan Am 73 was hijacked. And because it was an American carrier, you got enough information about it over there. And then it just died. One fine day, there was no more information. At another level, it, I think, bothers me when, you know, there's a famous saying that those who don't learn from the lessons of history are condemned to repeat them. You can't forget your heroes. If you go to any other place, wherever, even today, if you go to Pearl Harbor, you know, in Hawaii, there's a big plaque that, you know, basically implying that we'll never forget. And so we tend to forget our heroes, and we tend to forget our heroines even more, which is extremely. That if you're doing production, then with 20 odd years of goodwill as a photographer making people look good, I'm sure I could have put together something that was a simpler story. So if you rewind, like I was saying, if you rewind now and you say, let's make a film that will cost more than Kahani and more than Khoobsurat and more than the most of the female oriented films that are there, and we'll headline it with Sonam and Shabana, and we'll take a new director who's never done a Hindi film. Are you mad? It's a logical sort of thing. But I just have a personal theory, not based on any data or anything. I just think that if you're taking a family of four to a theatre, it costs you $2,000 after you pay for overpriced popcorn and parking and so on and so forth. Now, so earlier you went to watch a movie every week. People now think twice about, you know, should we spend $8,000 this month on drinks? So give me a very good reason to go to the theatre. Okay, because my options for visual entertainment are many. So, which basically brings us down to making a script that's effectively, the term Ram and I were using was actor proof. It can never be director proof. But let's make something that on paper is so good that anyone who reads it, first response should ideally be, this is terrific, let's make this movie. Oh, by the way, who's the actor? Should be the way, in our book, how it should work. We are no experts, but we just thought this would be a good way to approach it. So that was the thing. So we made the story, and we've been talking to Sonam for a while. We said, you know, let's put something together that we really think you should be doing. Because it is not in her general nature to do the song and dance routine. She's one of the best read people I know. She actually has read every book you can think of. I mean, I love that sort of thing. I collect books like this. So she's one of the few people who actually reads and actually collects hardcover books, and, you know. So so I think at one level she's very cerebral in things like this. So it's for her to. So we said, okay, what's the worst that'll do is we'll screw it up. It's happened to everybody before. But if we get it right, maybe we'll get it really right. And she said, okay. So we ran the 7-pager by her. She loved it. And we said, okay, we're developing the script. We'll come back. Meet Ram. They hit it off well. And then working with him is a delight. Because A, I've always believed that he's genius in terms of what he does. But nobody else figured that out till Feb 19. The other thing is, we have a very high level of mutual respect and trust. So he knows that I have his back, and I know that, you know, Likewise. So my job, as I saw it, was to create a cocoon around the director. And what is it that you need? Whatever you need, you open your little cocoon and, you know, tell me and I will get it. So even when he's, for example, in a discussion with Chavan, I would leave the room. So it is not my place. It's a sacred space between a connection between a director and an actor, and they need to have each other's complete and total trust. So if he's having a conversation, I would leave. So there's no ego on the producer. And so we just had two things. One was that I said, nobody has the patience. My test for a Hindi movie is, did you look at your watch? No more than 2:10, and whatever happens, we will not go over. So we came in under budget, which is a term very rarely heard. And 4 days ahead of schedule. We finished shooting 32 days, including one day of packing. Due credit to Rucha Pathak, who's been an old friend. She was serving her notice at the time. She said, listen, this is excellent. I'm moving to Fox. When I move there, the first phone call I will make to you is to you. And she kept her word. So she backed it continuously. She backed a Maverick director's vision of how he wanted to shoot it. I don't know if you're aware how he shot it, but it's quite remarkable. That's why our background action doesn't look like background action. It looks very, very real. The way he shoots it is, there's a life before action and there's a life after cut. Somewhere in between. So he's running takes. There were takes for 2 hours. And, you know, there were routinely takes for 25, 30, 40 minutes. So many terabytes of data go through. So hats off to the editor. So after a while, you get into the Big Boss house, effectively. You know, so, and you throw these various googlies at people. So Sonam didn't really have an idea that the guy is going to... Everyone seen the movie? Okay, so she didn't have an idea that he was going to ask her to sing a song. He had told her ki he could seek lena gaane. Rajesh Khanna can just learn something and whatever. He said, it will come off you. That's it. But she doesn't. Next thing you know, there's a gun in her face and gaana gaane. She's fantastic. I was confident all along that we'll make a good film. I was confident all along that we'll make a film that we'll be proud of. The only hope I wanted to have was that the Manoj family and passengers were not in any way disappointed. Because they've said no, they've lost count of the number of times they've said no to people over the last 30 years. Because they just thought that in some way it'll be over-dramatized or for lack of a, whatever, I mean, made filmy in some form. They had an issue with that. I approached them after I read Saibin's 7-page. I told Saibin, it's not in our nature to do something, although it's in the public domain, you don't technically need to take permission. But it's not something I would ever do. So they said, we'll do it with the blessings of the family, or we won't do it. So I called them, I met with them. They said, so what have you done? Nothing. So they looked at each other, Anish and Akhil, and they said, who's the director? I said, Ram Madhavan. So who's he? What has he done? He did nothing. So he's made many actions. So he says, are you totally mad? Why would we give it to you? We've said no many times. I said, we'll make an honest. We'll see to it that we don't let Neetra down in any way and her memory down. That we promise. So maybe it was our honest choices. So they said yes. I hired a researcher who went and met anybody who was willing to be on camera, spoke to whatever. So it's very interesting. Our perspective on it was, you're in a 200-300 foot long aluminum coffin. You might have heard something behind you, but you did not dare look back. You might have seen something from your perspective and a grey event or something. Now, the point is that it's different. It's a Rashomon-esque kind of point of view. You know, like different people are seeing differently. You're not wrong, you're not wrong, you're not wrong. You're not completely right either. So everybody has their own perspective on what has happened over 16 hours, 30 years ago. You know, which is also then prone to memory lapses, embellishments, you know, fantasy, exaggeration, whatever. So you'd be very, very careful, especially when you're dealing with people who passed away. This is the worst hijacking trauma in history. The most number of people dead and injured ever. So I don't think people realize that. So which would have been even worse if she had not opened the door and got people out. So, like if you see the aircraft pictures in the aftermath, it's shocking. I mean, it's just absolute unbelievable.